بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، welcome back dear brothers and sisters to juz number 6, whereby we find the completion of Surah An-Nisa, 176 odd verses Surah An-Nisa, and the theme, as we mentioned inside Surah An-Nisa, of ahkam and rules and regulations, and Ahlul Kitab, people of the book, Al-Yahud wa Nasara. The theme continues inside Surah An-Nisa, or specifically begins to speak about refuting the Christian belief about Isa alayhi salam. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. They did not crucify him, they did not execute or kill him. Indeed, it seemed or made look apparent to them that they had carried out this action. بَلْ رَفَعَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. But indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him up to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Isa alayhi salam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a cluster of the prophets together, showing the importance. إِنَّا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ كَمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى نُوحٍ. Indeed, we have given revelation to you like revelation was given previously prior to you to Nuh alayhi salam. And then a number of prophets are mentioned together. And there's a few places inside the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a number of prophets together inside Surah An-Nisa, inside Surah Al-An'am as well. A large portion of prophets are mentioned together. Then the surah concludes as it began with, by speaking about inheritance. And this is a general theme at times inside the Quran, that the beginning of a surah and the end of a surah will have the same theme. And even at times we find at the end of a surah and the beginning of a new surah, the same theme could spill over, or there could be a linkage between the two surahs. And this is ulama mentioned, like Imam al-Suyuti, a rabt bayn al-ayati was-sur, a relationship, a link between various verses of the Quran and various surahs of the Quran, how to interlink them together, or how the theme or the story or the ayat, they continue. We enter into Surah Al-Ma'idah, the fifth surah of the Quran, which is approximately 120 verses that we find. A Medinan surah, and once again, predominantly speaking about ahkam, rules and regulations, and the theme of Ahlul Kitab, it continues revolving around the Christians and the Jews. And as we mentioned, this is common throughout Surah Al-Baqarah, Al-Imran, Al-Nisa, Al-Ma'idah, Al-An'am, Al-A'raf. To a large degree, the whole, most of the Quran, it revolves around the theme of these two groups of individuals. Surah begins by highlighting, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu awfu bil-uqood. Or you believe, be truthful to your covenants, your promises, your agreements, your contractual agreements that you make, fulfill them totally. So as we mentioned, this surah is also speaking about ahkam, rules and regulations, and what we need to do and what we need to carry out. Inside that first page or those first ayat, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions the concept that it's not just about making agreements, but making agreements which are based upon honesty and trustworthiness and cooperating with one another. وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Encourage one another towards piety and righteousness, and do not join together towards any form of enmity, hatred, bad practice, etc. Stay away from that. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْإِقَابِ. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe inside punishment. Then we find what is classified as the final verse of the Quran, as Imam Suyuti mentions, in terms of ahkam. Not the final verse in terms of revelation, but in terms of rules and regulations. This is classified as the final verse. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam only lived for 81 days after this verse was sent down. The verse number 3 of Surah Al-Ma'idah, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islam ad-deena. This day I have chosen for you Islam as your way of life and perfected all favours upon you. So follow the teachings of Islam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with the deen of al-Islam. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Allah mentions inside this surah, various passages speaking about the Quran, the importance of the Quran as being a form of nur, guidance and a clear book. And we mention, find various verses inside there speaking about ahkam al-Quran, using the Quran as a form of rule and regulation and justice, and not to turn away from it. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. So Allah mentions three times in three very close verses in proximity about the importance of the Quran, or judging via the rules and regulations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prior to this, we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions one of the stories inside the Quran, وَاتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ ابْنَيْ آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ. Narrate to them the story of the two sons of Adam alayhi salam. So one can go back and read the story of the two sons of Adam alayhi salam inside Qasasul Anbiya by Ibn Kathir, and likewise read the tafsir. Allah mentions also ways of coming close to Him. يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَهُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ. Or you believe it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, find a wasila, means of ways of coming close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once again, look at the tafsir Ibn Kathir to see the meaning of al-wasila. What is the meaning of this word, and what is the forms or ways of getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As ulama of tafsir have mentioned, of belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua to Him, carrying out of righteous actions and doing good deeds is all one of the main forms of getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we find in the conclusion of this juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Ya ayyuhar rasul balligh ma unzila alayka min rabbik, O Messenger, convey to the people that which has been sent down to you. So this is the task of us Muslims, to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to stay away from any form of shirk. And thus the juz, it concludes, or prior to its conclusion, we find Allah mentions very harsh words, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارِ. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, whoever associates partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ, Allah has made haram for the individual to ever enter into paradise. So the theme of this surah is one of tawheed, staying away from shirk. Do not become like the Christians who begin to worship Isa alayhi salam, or begin to take the Trinity as the Surah Al-Ma'idah refutes that concept as well. So us Muslims need to be careful about how staying away from any form of shirk or association with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not tainting our belief with that, because that is the ultimate abominable sin which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive and will prevent us from going into Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlighten us with the message of Tawheed from the Quran and from Surah Al-Ma'idah, to become Al-Muwahideen, people of Ahlul Tawheed and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.